is high up here, ain't we?
Yeah, this is the highest we've ever been.
Yeah, now my calculation is correct. We are now flying into Stradivarius.
I'm sure anxious to get to Los Angeles and see that CBS Television City. You know, I understand they got some really great new things there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, sure must be interesting, all right. You know, I'm anxious to find out how all that television stuff works.
What do you mean, how it works? Work by electronics.
Electronics? Well, what is that, Kingfish?
Well, Andy, now there's I can explain it to you. Electronics is something that if folks don't know how it works and it do, well, that's what it is.
Oh, yeah, I read all about that, but I didn't get it till now.
We are now climbing to 15,000 feet. Fasten your belt, please. May I help you, madam?
Yes, sir.
Pardon me, miss, but I ain't wearing no belt. Would it be all right if I tighten my suspenders? Oh, yeah.
Wow, 15,000 feet.
Yeah, now, boys, that beam be flying up here at 15,000 feet. I think this would be a good time to talk insurance to you.
Insurance? You sell an insurance personal, Kingfish?
Oh, yeah, Andy. Complete coverage of airplane insurance. Issued by the George Stevens multi-million dollar insurance company.
Well, what is this great coverage you got?
Well, Amos, now just see while we are flying up here at 15,000 feet, and that motor conks out, and we are headed for a crash.
Well, what about it?
Then my company will pay you $20 a week benefits long as you live.
They will, huh?
Yeah, and another nice little feature about this here, Brother Andy, the time of the payments don't start from the time that you smack the ground. It starts from the time that the plane goes into a nosedive.
Oh, I was earning money on the way down, huh?
Every second of it.
Oh, well, that's good.
Excuse me, mister, but who is you?
I'm the pilot, sir.
You the pilot? Walking around out here? Well, who's up there doing the driving?
When I step out, the co-pilot takes over.
Oh. And Andy? Now, I guarantee you that this insurance policy will protect you from all... mister. You wouldn't happen to be the co-pilot, would you?
That's right, sir.
Say, Kingfish, getting back to this insurance, can you write out a fast policy?
Look, Andy, I ain't writing nothing till I get more facts. Mr. Co-pilot, excuse me for protruding. And I don't want you to think I'm nosy or nothing. But who up there driving this thing?
Why, the automatic pilot, sir.
Oh, the automatic pilot. Now, look, Andy. I'm gonna write you this policy. But if that automatic pilot walk out of there, the whole deal is off.
Oh, me.
Hey, look, fella, there's Los Angeles down there.
Yeah. And I think I can see CBS Television City from here. And boys, we're heading right for it. Look at that.
That's fine. Now, let's try it from the top. Where's Cass Daly?
Miss Daly just ran out. She's on her way to Mr. Ackerman's office. Man, she's mad enough to bite somebody.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
You know, Hubble, with all these changes, we'll be lucky if we get this show on the air.
You can say that again.
Hubble, what am I going to do?
Well, you're vice president in charge of production.
I know, but you're vice president in charge of me. Hello. It's New York.
Oh, probably Paley again.
Hello. Yes. Yes, Mr. Paley. Yes? Yes? Yes, Mr. Paley. Robinson? He's right here in the office with me. Yes? Huh? He's pacing the floor. He wants you to sit down.
Yes, Mr. Paley.
Yes? Yes, Mr. Paley? Yes? No!
No?
It was the operator. She wanted to know if I was cut off.
Oh.
Yes, Mr. Paley. You can depend on us. Goodbye, Mr. Paley. Well, Hubble, Mr. Paley has dumped the whole thing in our laps. We've got to take care of the Jack Benny situation or else.
Well, Harry, it's all your fault. You were the one who asked Benny to make the appearance.
That's right. Put it on me. How did I know he was going to take over the whole show? And those acts he's tried to put in. Imagine dressing Don Wilson as a seal and having him balance a ball on his nose as Mary tosses him a fish.
Well, you saw how he was messing things up.
I've got an idea. Why don't you talk to him?
I talked to him for 3 hours. You can't insult the man.
Why not?
I tried. Now, what we've got to do... What's Cass Daly doing up here?
Boy, am I mad. Real. Tricks to play. I tell you, gentlemen, I refuse to go on with the show. I refuse. I will not do it. I won't.
Now, Cass, calm down. Calm down.
Well, what are you doing in that outfit?
Yeah. Ah, very good question. The wardrobe department. I wanted to look like Marilyn Monroe. And this is what they did to me. Just look. I look like President Monroe.
Now, if you just calm down.
Calm down, really? Golly, I walk into the studio. Cass Daly, a beautiful, seductive young girl. And look at me now. I look like an ad for Yummy Yogurt. I tell you, I just won't do it. I will not do it, and that's the end.
Harry,
you can talk to me all you want. I'm going to go see Daly.
Good night.
Oh, about that Jack Benny. I was interfering with the costume department.
Yeah.
Alan Young.
Did he do something naughty?
What do you want?
Well, I've been made the new electronic supervisor. I'm here to check your set and see that the education program comes in very clearly.
What have you got there?
Murine.
Well, that's the most ridiculous thing I have ever... Alan, who gave you this job anyway?
Who gave me the job? Why, nobody else but the producer, the creator, the director, the writer, the star of the show himself.
Oh, no. Oh, no. The Orson Welles of the Beaver Patrol again.
Hubble, we've got to do something about this. This is getting to be ridiculous. The thing is piling up.
I know.
Hello.
Ed,
look, I can't do anything about the sets. We've got problems up here, believe me. If you...
No, that's the other problem.
Ed, you'll have to handle it by yourself. I'm sorry. Just a moment.
We'll take care of it.
Lud, look.
Okay, we'll get the other...
Lud, you get the musicians and work it out yourself. We've got...
We'll get the other man to do it, though, but there are four more.
Ed, I can't handle it. Believe me.
Hello.
You just have to take care of that yourself.
I'm sorry.
Yes?
Well, you sound like you're trying to run the whole show yourself.
That must be Benny. Tell him we're tired of his interference.
We're tired of your interference. Who says so? Who says so? Mr. Ackerman and Mr. Robinson say so.
Is Benny mad?
Benny? That was Mr. Paley.
Pretend it would never end. Ah, oh, gee, isn't that beautiful?
One day we cry together.
No one to blame for this mess but ourselves. Here we have Television City costing millions and millions of dollars, and the entire opening can be ruined by one man.
Yeah. We should have thought of that before we let him put up the money. I still don't understand why we didn't go to the Bank of America for the $7 million.
Well, our board of directors was having a meeting discussing it, and Jack Benny walked in, and he happened to have the cash on him. Wherever did he get all those $2 bills?
Hubble, Jack von Valkenburg is arriving from the East. Maybe he'll have an idea.
Well, what will that make us look like, sending over the president of CBS Television?
Pardon me, I came to get a bars and take down to the show.
What are you doing now, Alan? Working for the prop department?
Oh, yes, just trying to help out. I even borrowed this overall from a friend of mine who is a real stagehand in TV.
Alan, For any assistance you can give us with this great dedication of Television City, CBS will be eternally grateful.
All got to help out. Nothing at all.
First they send us their old comedians, now their old uniforms.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, Mary. Mary, this is going to be the most wonderful show that you've ever seen. And you want to know something? I did the whole thing myself. Directed it, produced it, I'm starring in it. And Mary, Mary, I must tell you what I'm going to do at the finish. Get this. I'm coming out at the very finish of the show with my violin, you see, and in a blue spotlight, so it doesn't clash with my eyes, I'm going to play that song that I wrote. You know that beautiful song I wrote? When you say I beg your pardon, then I'll come back to you. When? Huh? All right, Mary, I'll wait.
What's she doing, boss?
She's taking an Alka-Seltzer. Can't understand it. She's the third one today. When you ask me to for... Huh? Mary, you'll have to talk louder. I can't hear you with that fizzing. But I hear fizzing. What, operator? That you hissing? Well, get off the line. Mary, I'll call you later.
Well, boss, your coat's ready.
Ah, thanks, Rochester.
You know, I read in the paper that this new CBS television studio is going to cost $7 million.
That's right.
That's a lot of money.
Yes, sir. Imagine, Rochester, $7 million at 9%. Gosh, they gave me Arthur Godfrey as security. Say, Rochester, what's this? Ryan, what's this? What's this here? This dirt. Look at all this dirt on my sleeve.
Well, boss, people aren't as careful with it as you are. You ought to stop renting it out.
Who did I rent it to last?
Your butcher. He wore it to the meat packers' convention.
When you say I beg your pardon, then I... Rochester, what's this?
Grease.
Grease?
Yeah, when he brought it back, there was a pork chop in the buttonhole.
Then I'll come back to you. When you ask me to forgive you, I'll return. Right, there's the door. Answer.
Come in!
Look at that, I can do myself. Come in. Come in. Well, Desi. Desi, I am. Desi, where's Lucy?
Never mind that. Set up the screen, will you, Jess?
Inmediatamente.
Gracias.
Oh, I see. You're going to do that bit on our dedication show. I finally talked you into it, didn't I?
Meet my lawyer, Jose Gisler.
Your lawyer?
Malo que lo conozca en esta circunstancia, señor.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Jack, I am suing you for lousing up the filming of our show.
Your show, I Love Lucy? Well, how could I ruin it? I merely came over there to ask you to be on this dedication show.
Yes, I know. I know. And we told you that we would think it over. Mm-hmm. But you couldn't wait for an answer. Now, would you come over here and watch what you did?
What I did to the
show? Yeah, just come over here, will you?
I can't imagine what I
just sit down and watch, eh? Huh? Would you go ahead and run the fence?
Please, Ricky.
Absolutely not. And don't try to twist me around your little finger.
If you love me, you would. You don't love me.
I do, too.
You do not. What's my next line?
This is where you ask the waiter for the menu.
Oh. May I have the menu, please?
Oh, come on.
I'm not kidding.
Let's try it again.
Wait,
everyone
will
get home.
Hey,
action.
Fran and Ethel should be here in a minute. Well, here they come now.
Ricky, Ricardo, for the last time, are you going to let me be in that act or not?
No.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on. Hi. Let's go home. I don't care.
We might as well go home if it isn't going to be fun.
I want you to see the new line of chorus girls.
Oh, on second thought, my dear, I don't want to spoil your evening.
Please, Ricky.
Absolutely not. And don't try to twist me around your little finger.
If you love me, you would. You don't love me.
I do, too.
You do not. Would you get me... menu, please?
Doing here?
What's all the excitement about? Look, I just came over to find out if you're going to be on the show.
Well, couldn't it wait until later?
¿No te das cuenta que estamos trabajando aquí nosotros todos los días? Tenemos que estar en una televisión. Toda la semana tenemos que hacer el show. Usted se mete aquí y lo interrumpe todo exactamente.
Oh, then you are going to be on the show. Desi, Desi, it's such a simple thing. All you have to do is tell me where you go.
Gee, Jack Benny playing a waiter. Radio really must be...
Ricky, are you still mad? Ricky, talk to me. Are you still mad?
No, dear. Let's just forget it.
I can't forget it until I know you still love me.
I love you.
If you love me, you'll give me a great big kiss.
I
didn't mean to frighten you.
Oh, it's you again. Now, look, Jack, this is going
far
enough.
But I have to know tonight. Look, if you just promise me you'll come on the show, then I can be right on my way.
Action.
Ricky, aren't you finished yet?
What are you talking about? I just got here.
Haven't you even taken your shower?
Uh-uh.
Oh, I'll turn it on for you. You're going to be late. Say, listen, you ought to talk to Fred about that shower. You know, it stays cold for the longest time, and then it suddenly changes to scalding.
I know.
Yeah!
Oh, no! That's the dirtiest trick I ever heard of. You might have known I'd be in there. Now, look, Jack. Dazzy, I'll...
Look at I can't understand why you want to sue me. I wasn't so bad.
Look, Jack. Yo he estado en este país 15 años. Y esta es la cosa peor que me ha pasado aquí. Lo primero que me pasa, lo más ridículo y completamente catastrófico.
Well.
I shall see you in court.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute, Desi. Don't sue me. Look at Desi. I'll give you half of Arthur Godfrey.
Ackerman.
All right. Send them in.
What now?
Hello, Mr. Ackerman.
Hello, Mr. Robinson.
Hello.
Hello,
hello everyone.
No doubt Mr. Benny sent you over.
Well, you're a regular mind reader. Maybe you could also tell me when Millie's going to marry her boss's son.
Mama.
So I'm anxious. Kill me.
Please excuse Mama, gentlemen. Since the day I was born, she's been bucking for grandmother.
What was it Mr. Benny sent you over for, Millie?
It's what? About my poem.
Yeah, Alfred wrote a poem about our wonderful television city, and Mr. Benny wants you to hear it.
Yeah, he thinks it's good.
Well, we'd love to hear the poem, but we're very busy at the moment. I think some other time we might be able to listen to it.
You hate me. I'm gonna kill myself.
Alfred. Gentlemen, you'll save a lot of time if you'll just say you'll listen.
All right.
Oh, thank you. Please. Thank you. Ode to Television City by Alfred E. Prinzmetal. Hail to thee, child of CBS in Hollywood and New York. Tonight you were born weighing 2 million tons. Gee, what a strain on the stork. I thrill to you, massive structure. Over many an acre you spread. I love every rock in your garden. But I hope there's no rocks in your head. So all hail thee, mighty newborn child, whose body can never be bent, because your spine is made of steel. And your bottom is stuck in cement. The end. It's inspiring, isn't it? Where do you want me to take this green pod?
Just a minute. Take it to stage 33.
Okay.
All right.
Kids, we have 20 minutes till rehearsal.
I'll take this to the prop.
Pardon me. Are you one of the dancers on the show?
Yes. I'm a specialty dancer.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Alan, get that mannequin's leg and bring it over here.
Oh, mannequin's leg. Oh, I'll bring it.
Is
Luigi set and get another one. I'm sure you'll find one just like it in the antique room. In the antique shop.
Okay, I will.
All right, now get going! Oh, get out of here.
Okay.
Get going. Oh, hi, Mr. Linklater. What a day.
What a day. I have five little links at home. I have five kids on my house party every day. I come down here to do a song or a joke. I'm babysitting. With stars, kids, too. Who are you, anyway?
Stevie Crosby.
Crosby? Steve Crosby? Say, I know that name. Isn't your daddy famous and handsome and rich?
No, my daddy's Bob Crosby.
Well, he does something, though, doesn't he? What does your dad do?
He works every day.
Oh, that's fine. Brings money home and gives it to you, does he?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Now, well, let's find out what you'd like to be when you grow up, Stevie. Anything special?
A cowboy.
Oh, a cowboy. That's uh-huh. Say, by the way, do you have any girlfriends?
Yes.
How many?
One.
What's her name?
Charlotte Snyder.
What's her nickname?
What?
What's her nickname? What do you call her?
Chubby.
Oh, Chubby. Uh-huh. You gonna marry her?
Yes.
When?
When I get to be a papa.
Say, that hair. That hair, look at it. It feels like nothing could dislodge it, and you cut it. Who cut the hair?
I did.
Why did you cut it?
So I look like my father.
Oh, like your father. And here's a darling little girl. What's your name?
Liza West.
Well, I'm supposed to take care of you, Liza. What's your mother's name?
Eve Arden.
Oh, you're Eve Arden's little girl. And how old are you, Liza?
Seven.
Mm-hmm. Your mother ought to be down here pretty soon. I'm keep looking for her. Did she tell you anything special to do or not to do down here today?
She told me not to disturb the people.
Not to disturb who?
The people.
Oh, there are no people here. They're just actors. Now, Liza, What sort of a home life do you have? For instance, who does the most talking around the Eve Arden house, huh?
Hello. What?
Oh, George.
I can't find anything around this building. Do you know where Margaret Whiting is rehearsing?
Down in Studio 31, I think.
Oh, well, thanks.
Where's Gracie?
Oh, Jack sent her to the state capitol. She's the official escort for Governor Warren.
Gracie?
Yeah.
That takes a lot of courage.
Well, if he didn't have courage, he wouldn't be governor.
I just sang a new tune, and I want to see if you like it.
Oh, hey, what? Sure, sure.
Why don't you believe me?
for you, Margaret. I've got a wonderful idea. How about you and I doing a duet?
A duet?
Yeah.
George, who sent you over here? Dinah Shore?
Margaret, this is my own idea.
Oh, well, listen, there's a lot of singers on this program. Have you tried...
Everybody.
Oh. Well, all right. I'll tell you what, let's ask the sportsman to join us and we'll make it a big production.
How about it might as well be spring?
Wonderful.
Good idea. Do you know it?
I'll fake it.
Yeah. Well, what key does Mary Alonzo sing this in?
D flat.
One tone higher for
all
me,
right,
please.
All right, fine. I'm
as restless as a willow in a windstorm. I'm as restless.
I'm as jumpy as a puppet on a string.
I'd say that I had spring fever, but it isn't even spring.
I'm starry-eyed and vaguely,
starry-eyed and vaguely discontented, like a nightingale without a song to sing.
Oh, why must I have spring fever when it isn't even spring?
I keep wishing
I was somewhere else, walking down a strange new street.
I'm as busy as a spider
spinning daydreams. I'm as giddy as a baby on a swing.
I haven't seen a crocus or a rosebud or a robin on the wing.
But I feel so gay
in a melancholy way that it might as well be spring.
Might as well be. Hey, wait a minute, fellas. George, you can finish this.
You won't let me.
Well, yes, I will.
Would you boys like to finish it?
Yes.
Spring.
Yes, Kathy.
Have you seen Marie Wilson?
Why, no, Kathy, I haven't.
Oh, gee, she's got to get made up and get dressed and everything. Where is she? Marie? Marie, are you in there? Hi, Kathy. Dressing room in just a minute, Darren. Okay. Dressing room? Oh, hello, Mr. Robinson. Gee, you'd think when they built Television City, they'd made the dressing rooms a little bigger. Of course, I like this one better than the old one because it has a phone in it.
Is she like this offstage, too?
Uh-huh.
What are we paying writers for?
August.
Cookie, what does this say? What is that word? This word here?
Mm-hmm.
Room?
Well, what's the other one?
Ladies?
No. Well, I don't want to go in there.
Well, what can you expect from a girl who goes to night school to study trigonometry because she wants to know all about Roy Rogers' horse? You see, that's my friend, Irma.
Rochester, don't just sit there. Start, do something. Start the motors.
Yes. Maybe we're out of gas.
Rochester, how can we be out of gas? I put in a quart yesterday.
Boss, I've been meaning to talk to you about that. When you buy gas by the quart, every half mile you have to stop at a service station.
I know.
Well, why buy it by the quart then?
Look, Rochester, if I told you once, I told you 1,000 times. Gasoline evaporates. Let it evaporate in their tanks, not mine. Now go ahead, start it again.
Yes.
Pull out the choke. Hey, here comes Eve Arden.
Hello, Eve.
Hello, Jack. Rochester.
Hello, Miss Arden.
Jack, this is your car?
Well, Eve, I know what you're thinking, but I really have this car for sentimental reasons. You know, something old, something new, something borrowed.
And something blue.
Eve, why don't you come in the car and I'll drive you over to the studio.
Oh, huh? I'd love to, Jack. Thanks.
Right,
yeah. Oh, that's nice.
Well, Rochester, start it again. Well, I must say one thing. This car really has springs, doesn't it?
And in the darndest places.
Good, Rochester. Start it again, try. Rochester, get out of the car and see what's wrong, will you? Look under the hood there. Maybe there's something wrong with the motor.
Yes.
Now, look, Eve. Hey, here comes the mayor of Los Angeles. Come on.
Good to see you.
Mayor Barton, well, it's certainly good to see you.
Yeah.
Now, Mayor, did you get my letter asking you to speak at the dedication program?
Yes, I'm on my way down to the studio now, but my car stalled back here about 3 blocks, and I'm going down to a gas station.
Oh. Oh, did you run out of gas?
Yes, you see, the city buys it for me, a quart at a time.
You see, Rochester? Well, look at Mayor. Mayor, about as soon as we get this car fixed up, you know what I mean? Well, we'll drive you over to the studio.
Well, I'd be very pleased to go with you. You know, I'm very honored to be on this program tonight.
Uh-oh.
Well, all of us at CBS are delighted you could be there, Mayor Barron. Have you seen Television City yet?
Yes, from the very beginning, and it's fabulous. You know, the growth of this very spot of ground represents the growth and development of the city of Los Angeles. And you know, Jack, right under the studio is an oil field. They developed oil there, and then it was the site of motion picture production, and now Television City. It's a wonderful thing, and I take pride, as I'm sure every good American does, in this achievement. And I'm so happy that Los Angeles is the real center, a creative center for these United States.
Under this building, there's oil. Well, Rochester.
Well, maybe it'll start. I'll try it again.
Okay, we'll just get this thing started, right, Mayor, and then I'll drive you over. Go ahead, Rochester, try it. You better put on your straps. Your
Just won't start.
Well, Mayor, I don't think we can get it to work, so we'll have to do what we always do. You don't mind, do you?
Not at all. Let's go. Not so fast, you know.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? I'm fixing this loudspeaker so we can hear our call, boy. I don't want to stay in this room any longer than I have to.
What are you complaining about?
Oh, for goodness sake. 49 dressing rooms, and I got to share a dressing room with a girl.
Oh, stop beefing. It might help your high notes.
Ha ha. Well, I guess I might just as well make the best of it. What do you do with this stuff? Do you drink it or?
Put it on.
Put it on, huh?
Where's Crosby and McKenzie? They'll be right down, Lud. Let's run the number before they get here.
Gosh, we better hurry. They're calling us.
Let's try the number over once, huh?
Takes two to tango, two to tango, two to really get the feeling of romance. Let's do the tango, do the tango, do the dance of love.
You can sail on a ship by yourself.
Take a nap or a nip by yourself.
Like a you can get into debt on your own.
There are lots of things that you can do alone. What
takes to the tango, to the tango.
Tonight I'm all dressed up for the opening of a television city. Television, mamma mia, that's a new invention. They took radio, moving the pictures, and push them all in a little box. And this little box brings you programs from all over the country. And the sponsors, they love CBS. That's because when a man tells you to go to the icebox to get a can of beer, big guy comes out to see that you do it.
Luigi, my friend. Hello, Luigi, hello.
Hello, Pasquale.
Oh, look at the little banana nose, all dressed up.
Yeah, it's nice, huh?
Ooh. Where did you get that?
Well, I'm renting it for $1.25.
You got stuck?
Huh?
$1.25, what's this for?
Well, it's keeping me warm. That's the thing that...
Look at the sleeves, they're too long.
Well, the man who rented it said I'm gonna save money if I wear the long sleeves.
Why?
Well, he says if I wear the long sleeves, then I don't have to rent the gloves.
How come you get an invitation to this big art class affair?
That was Mr. Ackerman. He's my good customer. He gave me an invitation.
Oh?
See, look, it's a CBS television show, TV delicatessen show.
Let me say that. Your brains is in your stomach, the delicatessen. That's a dedication.
Dedication, what's that?
Well, that's, anybody knows... Well, it's altogether a different kind of star.
Oh.
Look, Luigi, I think...
Pardon me, I came down to borrow a vase for the show.
Are you doing something on the program, too?
Oh, yes, yes.
Hey, maybe you'd like a nice, beautiful girl for the chorus.
Well?
My daughter, Rosa.
Pasquale Rosa, he wants a girl and not the whole chorus.
Look, Luigi, please. Rosa! Rosa! Rosa!
You called me, Papa!
Yes, my little butterball. Rosa, say hello to... What's your name?
Alan Young.
Say hello to Mr. Young.
Hello, Mr. Young!
That's the way I feel it, too.
Ooh, what a combination. Young and beautiful. Hey, how do you think she would be on a TV set, huh?
No, Pasquale Rosa can't go on a television set yet.
Why not?
Because they don't have a 100-inch screen.
Look, if you'll excuse me, I think I better be running along. Pardon me.
Oh, wait a minute, Mr. Young.
Pasquale, I think Rosa likes this fellow.
Yeah,
young.
I think so.
I think maybe we ought to get him on our show, huh?
Why?
Then it's going to take a big load off of my hands. And off of yours, too.
Yes!
Governor, Mrs. George Burns is here to see you.
Mrs. George Burns? I've heard her husband sing, and I'm not going to pardon him.
No. She's new television city.
Oh, well, let her come in.
Yes, sir. Right in, Mrs. Burns.
Miss Burns, how are you doing?
How do you do, Governor Warren? Is it all right for me to call you Governor?
Of course.
All right, and you can call me Gracie.
All right, Gracie, how's your husband?
Fine. How's the governess? Oh, good. You know, I think we better get started.
Well, Gracie, will you wait just a moment till I check up on this part of my speech,
all right.
Please? I want to make sure that it's all right. Four important milestones were passed in the history of television this year. First of all, television network facilities have grown tremendously. Second, the FCC lifting of the freeze on the new television stations has opened the door to the full growth of television. Third, television has given you an example of its fantastic potential as a great mass communication medium during the political conventions. And fourth, a building exclusively designed for this medium now opens its doors. Facilities like Television City will help immeasurably, I'm sure, in making this medium one of the greatest mass communication tools we have ever known. I believe that CBS Television is to be congratulated for its vision and its courage. Now, let me see. I'd just like to add a little something to that.
All right. And while you're doing it, I wish you'd add something about taxes.
And what about them?
What about them? Oh, what do you do with all the money we pay in taxes?
Well, I can explain that. A part of the tax dollar goes to building highways and schools and hospitals. A part of it goes to running our courts and the rest of the tax dollar goes to paying the salaries of the governor and the state senators and the assemblymen and so on.
Mm-hmm, I thought so. Look, if you can do all that with $1, who gets the rest of the million?
Gracie, I'll look that up for you.
Yes. And another thing, if we pay your salary and all the others, then we're supporting you, aren't we?
Yes.
Then why can't we list you as dependents and deduct you?
I'll look that up, too.
Listen, Governor, tell me, do the Democrats have to pay part of your salary, too?
Oh, yes.
They're certainly rubbing it in, isn't it?
Gracie, don't you think that if you ought to write a letter to Washington, that's Washington, D.C., not to George?
Oh. Well, yes, I'm going to write him a letter and tell him about the senators you're sending there and the way they drink.
They drink?
Oh, yes. I read that Senator Nolan tried to make a speech from the floor.
Gracie, you don't understand.
Oh, I don't. And the Speaker of the House was even in a worse condition. Why, it said that he didn't recognize Senator Nolan.
Hey, Gracie, when you write that letter, will you let me mail it for you?
Of course.
Well, suppose you write it right now.
You write it
right here.
Right here in your chair?
Right here,
oh,
yes.
Yes.
You
right.
Just write it right there.
I hate to disagree with the mayor of Los Angeles, but there's no oil under this building. Now, ladies and gentlemen, for the benefit of our people at home watching the show, I would like to explain the how big the CBS Television City really is. Now, these buildings here, this magnitude, you know, in fact, we have this model made for that, you see. Now, these buildings cover an area of approximately 63,000 square feet, you see? And the air cooling system alone could make, I would say, about, well, 600 tons of ice per day, or enough to keep Phil Harris and Highballs for one entire evening. And there's enough concrete, ladies and gentlemen, in this building to build a highway, a two-lane highway, as a 8.5 miles long. Of course, we had to borrow some of the material, so in case you happen to be on the freeway tomorrow, you'll find a piece missing between Anaheim and Cucamonga. Now, right over here, ladies and gentlemen, right in this next...
Mr. Benny.
Oh. Well, I was just explaining, Television City to the people.
Mr. Benny, you have done your bit.
Well, now, wait a minute. Well, don't tell me that I've done my bit or how long to do. After all, you know, I'm the fellow that loaned all of this money to CBS, if you remember.
We're returning the money to you and getting it elsewhere.
What?
Just... Now, take your money and go.
Not until I count it. One, two, three, four.
Well, we've all had a lot of fun doing this dedication program tonight. And now, while Jack Benny is still counting his money, I'd like to present the real president of CBS Television, Mr. Jack Van Valkenburgh.
Thank you, Eve Arden, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking for all of us, for you, our viewers, and for all of us on the staff of CBS Television, I'd like to first of all give a very hearty thank you to all of the Hollywood stars that have made this program this evening such a notable success. And a special thanks to you, our viewers, for joining us in this dedicatory program from CBS Television City, a factory designed to bring even better CBS Television programs from the world's most important talent centers. Good night, Jack.
4,873,000. 4,874,000.
Good night, Jack.
Huh?
I said good night, Jack.
Oh, good night. Good night. Let's see, where was I? Oh, darn it. Now I got to start all over. One, two.
In full color from Television City in Hollywood, Chrysler Corporation presents Jack Benny. Co-starring Nanette Cabré, Connie Ray, special guest appearance, Rory Calhoun, starring in Power of Star. The brightest stars of Hollywood, brought to you by Chrysler Corporation, maker of the five great cars of the forward look, Plymouth, Dodge, DeSoto, Chrysler, and the exclusive Imperial. Chrysler Corporation. The